Okay, hi everybody. So this is interview number 6, 7, and 8 for the summer kickoff for the End Hunger Challenge for No Kid Hungry. So I have 3 more nominations that were nominated. We have a teacher, we have a nurse, and we have a dentist. A couple that I went to, a dentist, yes, that I never would have thought, thank you for correcting me, sorry, I never would have thought to interview, but they all have an impact on what they see for ending child hunger. So I kind of gave you guys a brief rundown of what the project was, that your interviews with me tonight helped raise $100 each, which is $300 collaborative for ending child hunger and 3,000 meals that we're raising just by standing together doing this. But one of the questions I ask most people is why, if you would have known ahead of time, why choosing to do an interview about ending child hunger would be important. So from kind of each of your aspects, what is it about ending child hunger that you guys see that would be so important? And what kind of strikes home with you from what you see that makes it such a big issue?
Just, well, having kids, we all have kids of our own. I mean, just wouldn't want to see any child be hungry. And as far as the dental aspect, getting, you know, good nutrition, preventing tooth decay, and, you know, just overall health.
So, and again, I guess I wouldn't have thought that initially. So, kids going hungry in schools has caused a real problem with...
Well, captain, if, you know, not getting the nutrition that they need, yeah, can definitely affect the teeth, which then can overall affect their...
And then what do you see with kids going hungry, and what do you see every day for you?
In nursing, if people don't get their right nutrition, they don't feel fast, they don't heal correctly, and it takes them a lot longer to heal, and then if people who don't eat a lot, they are sick for a very long time, and it's very hard to get them to where they need to be to be well. So great nutrition is important from birth on to be just overall healthy.
Do they get, is it kind of where they're just maybe sick longer, or do they get sick more often?
They get sick more often, they're sick longer. They don't have the nutrition to fight off the bacteria, they have the energy to fight off the bacteria or whatever is causing their illness.
And then teach them, correct?
Yeah, and so, you know, students learn better when they're comfortable in any setting. So if they're hungry and they're not happy and they're miserable, they're not going to learn as well. So keeping kids on, you know, well-fed is important.
A recent study came out. No Kid Hungry is a big thing, obviously, is making sure that all schools have breakfast. You know, trying to ensure that all schools have breakfast across the board. So that and working with teachers is a big deal. And one of the studies that came out, you know, teachers have been saying, we're kind of setting kids up for failure before we've even started by the lack of, you know, food, by, you know, not having breakfast in schools, or which I'm sure you see, they're saying, you know, their brains just tank, they're sluggish by midday. I mean, is that something that you see where they're just, their brains aren't even giving an advantage?
Yeah, it's a big impact on student learning. It's more nutrition.
So if there was one thing that you guys can say, because I know that obviously our time is short tonight, if there's one thing you can say to those students, say, well, you know, it's not my problem, right? I really don't care, or it doesn't affect me, and I don't have to do anything about it. Because I feel like I'm just, you know, talking to them blue in the face all the time, but one way or another, I'm getting the point across. What would be something that we could say to those that are watching the video that it does matter?
It matters, because those children are going to be your future, and they need to learn, they need to be in school, they need to be healthy, and the only way they can do that is to get the proper nutrition and education. Exactly, yeah.
You know, you guys, it might be a little bit different, because I've interviewed most of the band already, and they actually nominated you guys, so it might be a little bit different because they actually nominated you. But what I typically do with my interviews when I interview other celebrities, since it's the entertainment industry and Hunger Challenge, is I give you guys a chance to nominate 3 people to keep the ball rolling, especially tonight. The more interviews we do tonight, the more money we raise. Who are 3 people you could think of to help out, to do an interview with us, just like you did, to kind of keep it going, raise money, raise awareness, and keep it going if you think would do an interview with us?
Oh, in the area?
Well, you know, it doesn't even have to be in the area. It can even be anybody. I mean, we've had people nominate just celebrities, and then I reach out to them on social media, and I do interviews with them. Just anybody that you think, or someone that would be.
My sister works for the city of Rainier. Everything that where you come from, what you eat, how you take care of yourself, and that makes you really
My younger brother David's inside right now, and he's very into youth services and Christian stuff with his church.
All right, well, we can probably snag him tonight. The others will have to get a hold of. So that was 6, 7, and 8 tonight. So we are up to $800 for the End Hunger Challenge, which is also going to be matching $800 donated to the Brainerd area as well. We're going to keep the ball rolling, see how much we can get by the end of the night. So stay tuned for the next video round, and thank you guys very much.